binary operation or composition circle in a set G is a mapping, that is a function from G cross G to G. That is, if circle is a function from G cross G to G, then the circle is called a binary operation. The circle may be addition or subtraction or multiplication or division or combination of these basic operations. In this case, if the circle is a binary operation defined on a set G, then the set G is closed under the operation circle. And the definition of the closure property is, take any two elements from G. The operation is operated upon the elements A and B, and the A circle B becomes a single element that belongs to G. In that case, star is a binary operation in G, and this property is called a closure property. A set with one or more binary operations is called an algebraic structure, because truth theory is an algebraic structure. A set with one or more binary operations is called an algebraic structure. We already discussed some of the examples of binary operations. If circle is a binary operation on G, then the ordered pair G comma circle is an algebraic structure. So the algebraic structure is denoted by an ordered pair in which first we have to mention the set, then followed by the operation. And hence, if circle is a binary operation on a set G, then the ordered pair G comma circle is an algebraic structure. Examples: n comma plus, set of natural number with respect to addition. Z comma plus, set of integers with respect to addition. Q comma plus, set of rationals with respect to addition. Similarly, set of real numbers with respect to addition, set of complex numbers with respect to addition are algebraic structures with only one binary operation, namely addition. N comma plus comma multiplication, the set of natural numbers obey a closure property with respect to addition and multiplication, or we can say plus is an binary operation on set of natural number, and multiplication is also a binary operation on set of natural numbers. Therefore, the ordered triads, three numbers are there: n comma plus comma multiplication and r comma plus comma multiplication are algebraic structures with two binary operations. We too have algebraic structures with three operations, four operations, five operations, so on. For example, capital R. Capital R is a set of real numbers which has three simple operations, namely addition, multiplication, as well as subtraction. So these are examples of binary operation. So what's a binary operation? A set with one or more binary operation is called an algebraic structure. The notation is ordered pair G comma circle, or here ordered triads N comma plus comma multiplication. So this is the definition of algebraic structure. Let us recall some of the basics we have learned in previous classes. A plus B plus C is equals to A plus B plus C. This is known as associative property with respect to addition. That is known as additive associativity. with respect to multiplication, this becomes A into B into C is equals to AB into C. This is known as multiplicative associativity. Generally, in associativity, we simply change the bracket. A plus 0 equal to 0 plus A equals to A. If you add any number with 0, the answer is always the number itself. And this property is known as additive identity. Here, this 0 is identity element. A is any element. 0 is the additive identity. Therefore, A plus 0 equal to 0 plus A equal to 0 is known as additive identity. Here, the 0 is known as identity element with respect to addition, because the operation here is addition. What about multiplication? If you multiply any number with 1, we get the same number. That is, A into 1 is equals to 1 into A equals to A. And this property is known as multiplicative identity. Here, the number 1 is a identity element with respect to multiplication. So, in general, 0 is the additive identity, 1 is the multiplicative identity. In the case of vectors or the case of matrices, these 0 and 1 may vary. In the case of 0, it may be 0 vector or 0 matrix. We are going to have some problems, very interesting problems, in which the 1 is not the multiplicative identity. But in general, whenever you discuss about the number system, 0 is the additive identity, 1 is the multiplicative identity. What about this case? A plus minus A. We know A plus minus A is 0. 5 plus minus 5 is 0. 8 plus minus 8 is 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. So what is case? This is known as additive inverse. This minus A is the inverse of A. Whenever you add two numbers, if we get equals to the identity 0, then these numbers are known as inverse numbers. They are inverse to each other. Inverse of A is minus A. Inverse of minus A is A. Here we use the operation plus, therefore it is known as additive inverse. And hence, minus A is the inverse of A with respect to addition. What about multiplicative inverse? It's very easy. If you multiply two numbers, that number must be equals to 1, because 1 is the multiplicative identity. What is that number? It is quite obvious that if A is one number, then 1 by A is another number, so that A and 1 by A can cancel, we get 1. And hence, this property is known as multiplicative inversion. That is, A into 1 by A equals to 1. And remember that here 1 by A is the inverse of A, or A is the inverse of 1 by A with respect to multiplication, because here the operation is multiplication, therefore it is known as multiplicative inverse. So if we see the inverse property, what is on the right hand side? With respect to additive inverse, 0 is on the right hand side. What is 0? 0 is the additive identity. In the case of multiplicative inversion, what is on the right hand side? 1. What is 1? 1 is multiplicative identity. Therefore, if you want to find additive inverse or multiplicative inverse of any element, we should know the identity. So after finding identity only, we'll go for inverse. What is this property? A plus B equal to B plus A. If you take any two natural numbers, 5 plus 3 is 8. that's equal to 3 plus 8. And this property is known as additive commutativity. What about multiplication? With respect to multiplication, it becomes AB is equals to BA. Result is known as multiplicative commutativity. So here plus, therefore additive. Here multiplication, therefore multiplicative. So additive commutative property with respect to addition is A plus B equal to B plus A. Commutative property with respect to multiplication is AB equals to BA. And what is this property? A into B plus C, that is equals to AB plus AC. This property is known as distributive property. What happened here? The multiplication by A is said to distribute over addition of B and C. See, B and C are joined with the plus sign. Before that we have a A. Therefore, multiplication by A is said to distributive over the addition of B and C. So we say multiplication is distributive over addition. This is known as left distributive property. Similarly, we have right distributive law or right distributive property. So these are the properties we are going to discuss in group theory, rings and fields. In group theory, we'll be using closure, associativity, identity, inverse, commutative. The distributive will be using in rings and fields only. That is later on. Now we have some definitions. A set in which a binary operation is defined is called a groupoid. What's groupoid? A set in which a binary operation is defined. So a groupoid is nothing but an algebraic structure. What is an algebraic structure? A set with one or more binary operations is called an algebraic structure. Therefore, there is no difference between groupoid and the algebraic structure. See, when you say structure, we have to mention both the set and the operation. But in groupoid, we mention about only the set. A set is called groupoid. Set is called groupoid, which should have a binary operation. Therefore, groupoid and algebraic structure, both one and the same. And the important thing is, when you say algebraic structure, we have to give the structure form. That is, ordered pair G, comma circle. Examples. We know that the plus is a binary operation. That is, addition is a binary operation on set of natural numbers, set of integers, set of rationals, set of reals and set of complex numbers. And hence, N, comma Z is a groupoid. Z, comma plus is another groupoid. So these are all examples of groupoid. And they're also known as algebraic structure. N, comma plus is algebraic structure. Z, comma plus is also an algebraic structure. The next one is a semigroup. A semigroup is a set together with a binary operation that satisfies the associative property. Just now we discussed what is an associative property. And remember that here we haven't mentioned the operation. We simply said binary operation. It may be addition, subtraction, division or combination of any of these basic operations. So what's a semigroup? A semigroup is a set together with a binary operation that satisfies associative property. Therefore, semigroup will be having two properties. What are two properties? One is closure. But we haven't mentioned the closure. When you say a set with a binary operation, the set is closed. When you say a set is with a binary operation, we say that the set under the consideration is closed under the binary operation. Therefore, whenever there is a binary operation, the set is closed. You need not mention about it. But while doing problem, we verify. But in the definition, we don't mention the closure property here. The reason is already we have a binary operation, and hence a semigroup must satisfy two conditions. One is closure property. The second one is associative property. A set with associative binary operation is called a semigroup. Thus, here we have a definition of groupoid and semigroup. What's groupoid? Groupoid is nothing but a set with binary operation, or we say the set must satisfy closure property. That's all. A set must satisfy closure property. If any set satisfies closure property, is a groupoid. What is semigroup? Any non-empty set which satisfies two conditions. What are they? Closure property and associative property is known as semigroup. The third one is definition of monoid. What is groupoid? A set with a binary operation, or we say a non-empty set which satisfies closure property, is known as groupoid. What is semigroup? A semigroup is a set which satisfies two conditions, that is closure and associativity. Semigroup satisfies two conditions. What about monoid? It should satisfy how many conditions? Three conditions. What are they? One is associative. Next one is structure. When you say structure, circle is there. Circle is a binary operation. Therefore, it satisfies closure property. What's the third condition? There exists an element E belongs to E, such that A circle E equal to E circle A equals to A for all A belong to G. What is this property known as? This is known as identity property. Or we say existence of identity. A circle E equals to E circle A equal to A. Here the circle may be addition, subtraction, multiplication, or any of these combination of any of these binary operations. So here E is known as additive element, or we say this property is existence of identity. Thus, a monoid should satisfy three conditions. What are the conditions? Closure, associative and identity. Examples: Z comma plus is a monoid with identity zero, because if you add any natural number with zero, we get the same natural number. Therefore, Z comma plus is monoid. Why it is monoid? Here plus is a binary operation, therefore Z is closed and also satisfies associative property, and it, the identity is zero. Therefore, Z comma plus satisfies three conditions, and again Z comma plus is a monoid. Set of natural number comma plus, is it a monoid? Set of natural number with respect to addition, it is not a monoid. Why? Set of natural numbers with respect to addition is closed. That is, it satisfies closure property. It also satisfies associativity, but there is no zero in set of natural numbers. Therefore, he is not a monoid with respect to any operation. Z comma multiplication, that is set of integers with respect to multiplication, is also a monoid. What is the identity element here? 1. Let us recall once again. What is a groupoid? Groupoid satisfies only one condition. What is that? Closure property. Second one is semigroup. What is semigroup? Semigroup satisfies two conditions. What are they? Closure and associativity. The third one is monoid. What is monoid? Monoid should satisfy three conditions. They are closure, associative, and identity. So far we have learned what is a binary operation and the examples of binary operations and the definition of closure property, definition of associativity, definition of identity, definition of inverse, then monoid, groupoid, semigroup, monoid, The final stage is the actual definition, namely definition of a group. A non-empty set G together with a binary operation circle on the set G is said to be a group if the following conditions are satisfied by the elements of G. What are the conditions? The conditions are, the first one is closure property. What's the closure property? A circle B belong to G for all A comma B belong to G. That is, we take any two elements from G and operate upon the operation, the final element must be in G. That is called closure property. The second one is associative property. What is associative property here? A circle B circle C equal to A circle B circle C. It is true for all A comma B comma C belong to G. Take any three elements and this condition must be satisfied by the elements of G. Third one is, there exists an element E belongs to G such that A circle E equal to E circle A equal to A for all A belong to G. There exists an element E in G such that A circle E equal to E circle A equal to A for all A belong to G. This is known as existence of an identity. Here the element E is called an identity element. What's the fourth property? The fourth property is, to every A belongs to G, there exists an element A inverse belongs to G such that A into A inverse is equal to A inverse into A equals to E. This is known as existence of an inverse. So how many properties are there? How many axioms are there? There are four axioms. What are they? Closure, associative, identity and inverse. Thus, an algebraic structure satisfying the four axioms, namely closure, associative, identity and inverse, is called a group. So this is the definition of a group. A non-empty set G together with a binary operation circle on G is said to be a group if the following conditions are satisfied by the elements of G. What are the operations? Closure, associative, identity and inverse. Just now we discussed three definitions: groupoid, semigroup, then monoid. And we know that an algebraic structure satisfying closure property is called a groupoid. Therefore, if the algebraic structure satisfies this closure property, which is called a groupoid, the algebraic structure satisfying two axioms, what are they? Closure and associative, is known as semigroup. Remember that. Why it is called semigroup? Because for a group, how many axioms are there? Four axioms are there for a group. Semi means half. Half. What is half of four? Half of four is two. Therefore, a algebraic structure satisfying first two properties is known as semigroup. An algebraic structure satisfying first three properties, namely closure, associative, identity, is known as monoid. An algebraic structure satisfying all the four axioms, namely closure, associative, identity, inverse, is known as a group. So we have groupoid, semigroup, monoid, then group. Note, the binary operation defined on G has the closure property, that is A circle B belongs to G for all A comma B belong to G. This, whenever there is a binary operation, the set is closed. or it satisfies the closure property. In E circle A equal to A, E is called left identity because E is in the left of A. And A circle E equal to A, then E is called right identity because E is on the right side. In the above definition, the element E is called an identity of G. The element A inverse is called an inverse of A. And remember that AB whole inverse and AB inverse are not necessarily the same. The next definition is abelian or commutative group. A group G, comma circle is said to be abelian or commutative if A circle B equal to B circle A for all A comma B belong to G. That is, a group satisfies commutative property is called commutative group. It is also known as abelian group. Why it's called abelian group? The reason is abelian groups were named after the mathematician Niels Henrik Abel by Camille Jordan, because Abel found that the commutativity of the group of a polynomial implies that the roots of the polynomial can be calculated by using radicals. So it was introduced by Abel, and hence this group is called abelian group. A group will have four axioms, whereas abelian group will have five axioms. A group G comma circle is said to be a finite group if the set G has a finite number of elements, and it's said to be an infinite group if it has infinite number of elements. But here we discuss both finite group as well as infinite group. In this case, the number of elements in G, in the case of finite group, the number of elements in G is called order of G and denoted by modulus of G. Thus, we have learned what is an algebraic structure, what is a closure property, associative property, identity property, inverse property, commutative property, then monoid, semigroup, groupoid, and group, finally abelian group. Once again, we recall what is algebraic structure. A set with one or more binary operation is called an algebraic structure. What is group? A group will satisfy four axioms. What are they? Closure axiom, associative, identity, and inverse. In general, zero will be the additive identity. One is a multiplicative identity. The next one is abelian group. Abelian group will have five axioms. They are closure, associative, identity, inverse, and commutativity. So we'll discuss some problems. Once we discuss some problems, then you can understand the real application, the real meaning of group. The first example is N does not form a group with respect to addition and multiplication since inverse does not exist. N will not form a group because 0 is not there. When 0 is not there, you cannot find inverse also. For 5 belongs to N, inverse of 5 is minus 5. But minus 5 is not in N. And even 0 is also not there in N. Remember that 0 is also not there in N. The second one is Z comma plus is a group. The set of integers with respect to addition is a group. But Z with respect to multiplication is not a group since inverse does not exist. Because 5 belongs to Z. What's the inverse of 5 with respect to multiplication? It is 1 by 5. It is 1 by 5. But 1 by 5 is not in set of integers. Therefore, with respect to addition, set of integers forms a group. But with respect to multiplication, it is not a group at all because inverse does not exist. In the case of set of natural numbers, identity does not exist and inverse does not exist. Whereas in the set of integers with respect to multiplication, identity exists. One is the identity, but inverse does not exist. For example, 5 belongs to set of integers. Inverse of 5 is 1 by 5, which is not there in integers. We know that integers has only positive numbers and negative numbers, no fractions at all. The set of integers for subtraction is not a group. The reason is associative law is not valid. We know difference of two integers is again an integer. A minus B or B minus A is an integer. But in the case of associativity, it is not true. Let us take it. A circle, B circle, C equals to, what is circle here? Circle here is subtraction, because circle is a binary operation. We have taken the operation is subtraction. Therefore, it is A minus B, B minus C is equals to. Now remove this bracket, then we have A minus B, minus of minus is plus. So A minus B plus C, called as 1. What is the other part of associativity? A circle B, circle C. Now what is A circle B? Circle is replaced by minus sign, because here the operation is minus, subtraction. That is equals to A minus B minus C, called as 2. Look at this 1, A minus B plus C. 2 says A minus B minus C, and hence 1 and 2 are not equal. Since 1 and 2 are not equal, or the right hand side of 1 and 2 are not equal, left hand side of 1 and 2 are not equal. And hence A circle B circle C not equal to A circle B circle C. That is, associative law fails here. Associative axiom fails here. Associative property fails here. You can say property, axioms, law, yeah, all, anything you can say. Therefore, set of integers with respect to subtraction is not a group. So set of integers with respect to addition is a group. Set of integers with respect to multiplication or subtraction is not a group. Q comma plus is a group. What is Q? Q is set of integers with respect to addition is a group. But Q with respect to multiplication is a group, but with respect to division is not a group. The reason is it does not have associative property, as we discussed in the above case. The set of all non-zero real numbers forms an infinite abelian group. Infinite abelian group with respect to multiplication. Set of complex number C with respect to addition is an infinite abelian group. The set of all vectors with respect to vector addition forms an infinite abelian group. The set of all matrices whose elements are set of integers, set of rational, set of real, set of complex forms an infinite abelian group with respect to matrix addition. What about with respect to multiplication? We will usually simply write AB for the product A circle B. Sometime what happens, we don't use a, you don't mention the binary operation. In the base of A circle B, sometime we write AB, nothing wrong in it. But when you write in the examination, you have to mention the operation. Now we have some properties of groups. The first property is, if G is a group, then identity element of G is unique. Similarly, in a group G, inverse of any element is unique. Cancellation law is plays an important role. If G is a group, then AB equal to AC implies B equal to C. Here it's like AA cancels like. See here? AA cancels. So what is left over? B and C. Therefore, AB equal to AC implies B equals to C. This is called left cancellation law. Similarly, we have a right cancellation law. BA equal to CA, which implies B equal to C. Here, we are cancelling this A. Where is A? A is on the right hand side. And which implies B equal to C. This is called right cancellation law. For all A comma B belong to G, provided the A is not a zero element. A should not be zero. If A is zero, this rule cannot be applied. Remember that here A, B, A and B are elements of G with a condition that A should not be equal to zero. If it is multiplication, addition, I say okay, no problem. If it is multiplication, here A should not be zero. That's why I haven't mentioned A is not equal to zero, because multiplication, addition, it is true. But when we discuss problems, we have to clearly specify whether A is zero or non-zero. These are the three properties. That is, identity element is unique, inverse is unique, and the cancellation laws holds good in groups.